Yeah, what we have here is a replica of a 1965, 1966 Corvette Grand Sport. This one's built by a company called Mongoose. This is the one, this is actually the only car out of, I think, 12 that we had on the film that we bought pretty much as is. We painted it, changed the color, changed the interior a little bit, but that's about it. This one was our hero car. It's equipped with the GM Performance Crate Motor 502, BorgWarner Super T10 transmission. Basically has like C3 Corvette suspension components underneath it. The wheels are a replica, a 17-inch replica of the 15-inch original. It's one of the more fun cars to drive. It's definitely a handful. It's you know, a huge motor, light car concept. Vin Diesel actually drives this car in the train heist sequence. We had a couple of these that were built basically in conjunction with a special effects department, you know, Matt Sweeney and his guys, that were built on VW off-road car chassis. There was a lot of footage, you know, going through all sorts of rough terrain, dirt roads, sand washes, and everything else. A lot of airtime, a lot of jumps, and that served to be the best way to do it, and they looked on screen just like you can't tell the difference. We had, I believe, somewhere in the neighborhood of 5 stunt cars. We had 3 cars that were rigged with an enormous air cannon, once again built by effects that, you know, spanned the length of the car for the shot where it goes off a cliff into a quarry. So, yeah, there's not a lot of these left. These cars definitely had a rough life on Fast Five. I think out of all of them, there's the Hero and 2 stunt cars that are still drivable, and that's about it.
Well, it certainly goes, and it stops pretty well. See how it corners. Well, I think those rear tires have seen some better days. It does power slides, absolutely no trouble at all.